Good morning. A big embrace to you all. In the name of God, our Creator, Jesus Christ, our Saviour, and the Holy Spirit who gives strength to the people of God. Amen. Figs. Who gives a fig about the week of prayer for Christian unity? We are on its eve. I want to tell you a story. Story of Nonna Maria, the Italian grandmother of our daughter-in-law, who gave instructions to Jane and I that we should be given a couple of her homegrown fig trees. This was just weeks before her death, 2 years ago. Unity can be found in all sorts of places, but over time it is food and music that can be an influence, a unifying influence. Nonna Maria, who was an industrious matriarch, in her Catholic devotion, welcomed my Anglican intermediary blessings when she was particularly poorly. Thank goodness those fig trees are still flourishing and sheltering for the winter. Do we know anyone with the name Nathaniel? Its meaning is from the Hebrew for gift of God. Jesus decided to go to Galilee and he found Philip. Philip found Nathanael, an Israelite without deceit, under a fig tree. You have seen nothing yet, says Jesus. I give you angels from all heavenly angles. Nat had declared Jesus as the Son of God and King of Israel. What we observe is what sustains us when we seek the kingdom of God under a fig tree or even by a clump of snowdrops. We can look for hope anywhere after the battering of the world events, both large and small. The fig leaf was helpfully used in the Eden Garden of Paradise. The fig is one of the oldest cultivated fruit, going back to Jericho 9,000 years before Jesus' birth. In the Roman Empire, it was part of their staple diet and also a cure for hemorrhoids, which I think we'd all be united in. We find unity as a church in Christ, in Jesus, in bringing a diverse group of people together, both male and female. The fig tree plays a part in today's gospel reading. The kingdom of God is about fruits, being brought to the vocation of unity that we are called to. Today is, in fact, the eve of the week of prayer for Christian unity. I want us to reflect just for a while on the meaning of the word unity. Where do we find it in the kingdom of God and the world of our churches of every kind? The secular meaning of unity is about the state of being united or joined as a whole. It is about our unity of purpose. The week is set aside for examining again what we have in common and is important. But the practice of our wider purpose in the world has been declared in these days. Like many things, it is about reaching out together, to meet the needs of our local communities. How we express that together is an ongoing adventure. In chaplaincy, in acute hospitals, mental health care hospices, GP surgeries, care homes, ecumenical chaplaincies in the last 30 years have the focus and purpose of seeking health. All difference between Christian denominations falls away and embrace those of all faiths and none. The unity of purpose reveals itself and the relationships blossom. Many take notice because the fruits are self-evident, meeting the need in front of us together. This year, the resources of the Worldwide Week of Prayer for Christian Unity have been provided by the Benedictine community of Grandchamp in Switzerland, with the title Abide in My Love, from John 15. Abide in my love, and you will bear much fruit. They are a community of 50 sisters, and out of their studies for the week, they have linked with Christian Aid with action points from the three vigil expressions that have been invited to share with the world. You can find it on the Week of Prayer for Christian Unity resources link. They have, in those three vigils, the titles of the unity of the whole person, the visible unity of Christians, the unity of all people with all creation. In these days, the search for wholeness and unity within us is, they say, from the search for the forces of calmness out of all the turmoil. They identify with the daily search for some silence where we can call on the creative word of God. This gives us the courage to have solidarity with the suffering and to nurture hope in each other. That leads us to become creatures of a new way of living with respect for and communion with all creation. In these weeks, the identifying with the suffering with all those in hospital care homes, those being treated in intensive care units and acute wards, is expressing our solidarity in thought and prayer and action. This is held in tension with all those involved in the distribution of the scientific wonder of the vaccines. We lift all those involved as we abide in the love of God in all situations at this time, those treating those with COVID-19. And let us remember all those who care in any way and those who we know who are on the front line of any sort. Grandchamp's community's vocation of prayer, reconciliation, justice and peace embraces the church and the Franciscans' human family. The Week of Prayer has its beginnings in 1908 with Franciscan friars, and in the 1920s broadened in its reach through the World Council of Churches. The Grandchamp community has its roots in the 1930s when this group of women of the Reformed tradition sought to discover the importance of silence and listening to the word of God. They represent different generations, church traditions, countries and continents. They are a living parable of communion and unity through developing community and welcoming guests seeking meaning and purpose. I can do no better than quote their introduction to their theme of abide in my love. For me, this answers the question in this special week of revisiting the meaning of unity and are addressed in these words. Jesus said to his disciples, abide in my love. He abides in the love of the Father and desires nothing other than to share this love with us. I have called you friends because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. Grafted into the vine, which is Jesus himself, the Father becomes our vine dresser, who prunes us to make us grow. This describes what happens in prayer. The Father is the center of our lives, who centers our lives. He prunes us and makes us whole, and whole human beings give glory to the Father. Abiding in Christ is an inner attitude that takes root in us over time. It demands space to grow. It can be overtaken by the struggle of the necessities of life, and it is threatened by distractions, noise, activity, and the challenges of life. We live in a time that is both troubling and magnificent, an often dangerous time where we are challenged by pandemics, wars, violence, poverty, racism, and climate change. Yet as Christians seeking reconciliation, justice, and peace, we also know the value of a spiritual life, have an immense responsibility and must realize it, unite and help each other create forces of calmness, refuges of peace, vital centers where the silence of people calls on the creative word of God. It is a question of life and death. They continue, though we as Christians abide in the love of Christ, we also live in a creation that groans as it waits to be set free, described in Romans 8. In the world, we witness the evils of suffering and conflict. Through solidarity with those who suffer, we allow the love of Christ to flow through us. The Paschal mystery bears fruit in us when we offer love to our brothers and sisters and nurture hope in the world. Spirituality and solidarity are inseparably linked. Abiding in Christ, we receive the strength and wisdom to act against structures of injustice and oppression, to fully recognize ourselves as brothers and sisters in humanity, and to be creators of the new way of living with respect for and communion with all of creation. The summary of the rule of life that the Sisters of Grandchamp recite together each morning begins with the words, pray and work that God may reign. Prayer and everyday life are not two separate realities, but are meant to be united. All that we experience is meant to become an encounter with God. The fruits of unity spread from local to global context. Today we give thanks for Nathaniel and we thank God for Nonna Maria and the community of Grandchamp, for all your care and the gifts you have showered upon us for this week and always. Unity is worth more than a fig, and so much more. It figures. And it is expressed for me in Ubi Caritas et Amor, where there is charity, love, God is truly there. Let us reflect by hearing the choir, and let us join in with Ubi Caritas.